We are in Windows Server 10. I'm going to show you how to promote a server to be a domain controller. So what we're going to do is open up Server Manager, which we have open right here. Click on the Add Roles and Features. Click Next. Leave the default role-based at the top and Next. And at this time, if you realize your server is not named the one you want, you probably want to go in and rename it and reboot before you continue. After that, just go ahead and click Next. At this time, go ahead and click the Active Directory Domain Services button. And when prompted, go ahead and choose the Add Features. And that's the only button you need to check at this time, and click Next. Now, this is the Features area. You can just go ahead and leave the default. Click Next. Next again. If you want to automatically restart, you can at the end when it's done. We'll go ahead and click Install. And we'll fast forward during the installation so you don't have to wait too long. All right, it looks like the installation is completed. And at this time, we can go ahead and click the Promote this server to be a domain controller. And we'll click on that link and we'll just wait for that to open. All right, so we're going to add a new forest since this is our first domain controller. And we're just going to go ahead and give it a name. It's a nice fake name. Definitely recommend you choose internal or local. Don't use two-digit letters because you might find that a country code has that and you might have a problem if you try to put it into production and it has an issue with certificates. So we'll continue on. The next screen comes up, asks you the forest functional level, domain functional level. At this time, we can choose the drop down and choose whatever function we want. Depends on if we have other domain controllers that are older than the one we have. So we'll go ahead and let this finish. It's done. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and choose the 2012 R2. This is the Windows Server 10 technical preview. So unfortunately, we don't have all the features we're going to have in the finished one. But we'll go ahead and type our directory services restore password in here. Now, this is normal. A delegation DNS server cannot be created. That's okay. Just go ahead and ignore that. Click Next. And while we're waiting, just to show you the version that we have here, if you right-click on the C drive, go to Properties, you can see that we're looking at the C drive tools. Looks very similar to 2012. Quota, previous versions, shadow copies, all those things, pretty normal. We'll go back to our server manager. Let's see our NetBIOS name. Go ahead and click Next. Next. And if we need to export a script for PowerShell to automate an additional installation, we can choose View the Script. You can copy that script and then save it as a .ps1 extension. Go ahead and click Next. And now we're verifying all the prerequisites. Windows Server 10, you can see the icons look a little bit different than they did in 2012. Go ahead and close that. And we'll click on All Servers again while we're waiting. And we'll choose Computer Management, see what that looks like. Again, very similar to 2012 R2. All right, let's see where we are. Looks like we're good. We'll go ahead and click install, and it says everything was successful there. And we can see this is Windows Server Technical Preview, and we can see that the type of server that we have, memory, etc., name of our server. And we see that the server is activated. Take a look at the start menu. See, that definitely looks more like it did back in 2008. Click on All Apps, Administrative Tools. Maintenance, it says it's empty at this time. Windows System. This is similar to what accessories used to be like. All right, looks like we were successful, and the server is going to be restarted now. Go ahead and click Close. And now we're restarting. All right, the server has rebooted, so let's go ahead and log in. And this time we'll use the right password. Unfortunately, it turned off my NumLock. So I've got to turn that back on after the reboot. So we have logged in with the new domain name. Widget LLC is the domain NetBIOS name. And we chose administrator. And we logged in. So instead of logging in locally, we logged into the domain. So after you create a domain controller, the local administrator account disappears off of the domain controller itself. All right, so Server Manager is opening for the first time, and we'll be able to open up the tools and look at Active Directory users and computers just to confirm everything is working properly. And there it is. So let's go ahead and open up Active Directory. And we should see our domain controller listed. And let's see, there's our Active Directory domain controller, and there it is. There's our domain controller. If you right-click, we can choose Operations Masters, and you can see that the master roles have been installed on the one and only server that we have in this network. So that is how you install Active Directory domain controller to a Windows Server 10 technical preview, which you can see right here.